The Illuminati wants your mind, body, and soul. We at war! Did you strap up your combat boots yet? Wacha!
Self-destruct sequence 3, 2, 1.
It's your boy Flat Archie 5000 about to hit you with some more of this ism. What we're going to talk about today is a little psychology, reverse psychology at that. One thing that you must know, you know, while living in this system of white supremacy is that nothing is what it appears to be. And this applies to every facet of life that you can possibly conceive, you know, especially after being indoctrinated with Eurocentric concepts and influences. But what we're going to touch on today is that, get straight to the point, is that Europeans don't say what they mean. You know what I'm saying? If you don't understand that in 2018, then you don't understand the system of white supremacy. The system of white supremacy was actually rooted by the mere fact of Europeans traveling the world and invading different countries and befriending different tribes and speaking with a double-edged tongue, and which actually boils down to the fact of how they were able to infiltrate different tribes. If the European came amongst you as in the name of Christianity, you best believe that he was more so of the religion of a Satanist. If the European says that he's coming with peace, you best believe that he's coming with war. If the European says that he loves you, you best believe that he actually hates you. This is not even up for debate, you know, and this is not my opinion. This is based upon, you know, history and facts. One thing that these Hollywood stars that are been propped up to be our iconic figures is that they would never ever get the respect that they deserve from Europeans, because even to transcend Europeanism, no country or no race on the face of the earth respects another race that doesn't have honor and loyalty to their own race. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna point out a person, point a case like Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather is one of the best boxers that ever lived. I mean, you know, his record is impeccable. I don't even have to actually break that down to you. Which is the reason why he's a multi-millionaire, you know, and he's treading towards being a billionaire. A person like Floyd Mayweather can reach that status. a person such as a Malcolm X, if he was a Malcolm X type of individual or a person who spoke like Ali, he would never ever be given the privilege to gain that type of notoriety or that type of power as far as financially, because people who speak out against the system of white supremacy are outcasted. You know, they're coming for you. They're coming for your throat. They are attempting to first assassinate your character before actually taking your life. And this has been played out all throughout the planet. Those of us who've raised up amongst the people as a beacon of light to save our people from the system of white supremacy or those who are considered the elites. Now, a person like Floyd Mayweather would never ever speak out against the system because he understands what he's actually up against. Not to say that even if he wasn't up against the system, I still do believe that he would still be cooning around, you know, which is one of the reasons why I don't respect Floyd at all, because he has no loyalty to his own race. The same principle applies to Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan has been raised up to be one of our famous athletic, iconic figures, to the point that everybody around the world has a pair of Jordan sneakers. If not a pair of Jordan sneakers, well, you damn sure was wearing a pair of Hanes at one point in time. And if not that, at the very least, you know who his name is and what it's associated with as far as basketball. This guy right here had all the money in the world, and so-called black people, so-called uneducated black people have raised him to pretty much be in within the ranks of God. But this guy right here has no loyalty to his own race. He doesn't date within his race. In fact, even outside of basketball, he has a real shitty attitude towards those who he deemed to be lower than him. So I hate to break your heart if Michael Jordan is your favorite basketball player and, you know, you got his posters on your wall and, you know, got a picture of Michael Jordan in your wallet or whatever the case may be. If you're wearing a pair of Jordans, you're wearing a pair of Hanes, trust and believe, this guy, this fella, is just as bad as a Donald Trump. You know what I'm saying? Because that's the way how he looks at you. And it's not my opinion. You could just go by the mere fact that he invested a bulk of his money into to prisons. You know, the guy invested his money into prisons. He took his basketball money and his sneaker money and his Hanes money and reinvested that into prisons. Now, mind you, so-called black people are the ones throughout the United States who populate the prisons. So the same brothers who were wearing his sneakers are wearing his sneakers in prison due to the fact of your iconic figure, Michael Jordan, pretty much funded the prison that you're in. I mean, talk about ignorance upon ignorance and talk about coonism upon coonism and house niggerism upon house niggerism. This ignorance has no motherfucking beginning, nor does it has any end. But back to your boy Floyd Mayweather. Floyd Mayweather would never ever use his money to benefit his own people. He has no loyalty towards his own people. In fact, most of those who he surrounds himself with as far as his bodyguards are all Europeans. You know, most of his best friends are Europeans. He's a so-called black athlete who was raised in the ghetto, raised in the boxing gyms, and he has no loyalty to his own people. The first thing that our people do is once we get money is that we, you know, first of all, we give it back to the Europeans, and then two, we date outside our race. And like I said before, no race on the face of the earth has no respect for no other race who don't hold an allegiance of loyalty to their own race. And even those within, let's just say hypothetically in China, You have Chinese people who date white people, Europeans. You have Chinese people who date so-called black people, and Chinese people who date Hispanics. Those people within the Chinese culture are looked down upon. The same principle applies to those who are in Mexico. The same principle applies to those who are in Korea, and the same principle applies to those who are in Europe. You know, you're looked down upon if you don't hold an allegiance to your race, to your nation. No matter what it is that they propagate through the media, you know, we're all one and we're all one color. It's all a hoax. It's all a farce. And like I said before, the European never says what he means. This right here is a tactic of war. He's playing chess with us. And the more and more that he can show images of interracial relationships and show images of black people, so-called black people, rappers, pushing dope, pushing alcohol, calling themselves pimps, it serves his agenda. The more that he can show athletes, black so-called black athletes and actors who are into interracial marriages and promote that within our youth, promote that through the media, the more and more we start to get trapped into the matrix and believe this Alice in Wonderland fallacy. You know, one thing about it, man, these Europeans are masters of tricknology. And you don't have to ask me. You can ask the so-called Native Americans. You can ask the so-called Africans in Africa before the year 1492. What was the technique? What was the interest of the European when he came into Africa under the guise of being Christian missionaries? And what was his technique to gain control of the land, which he has until this day? The same technique that he used amongst the Africans, or the same technique that he used amongst the Indians, the so-called Indians, the so-called Native Americans of America. Everywhere he go, he uses the same tactic of divide and conquer. I mean, you know, I can go on and on, but the coonism amongst our people is by far unmatched, and it's unheard of within the civilized realm. You know, this is just me, you know, exercising my five senses, you know, bringing you the truth, how I see it. It's your boy, Flat Archie 5000. I'm out. Peace.